Hello and welcome to Chairside Live. I'm your host, Megan Strong. Thanks for tuning in. In today's show, we're taking it back to the first ever Glidewell Dental Symposium. Dr. Raymond Choi is on stage giving his presentation, Indications for Small Diameter Implants. Let's check it out.
Dr. Raymond Choi is a general dentist who has placed implants for the past 20 years at his private practice in Tustin, California. He's assistant clinical professor at USC's School of Dentistry, founder of the Global Mini Implant Institute, and he is one of the first dentists on the West Coast to place small diameter implants for denture stabilization. Dr. Choi will present Indications for Small Diameter Implants, a discussion on the safe and effective techniques for using small diameter implants.
You would think that small diameter implants may not be strong to support a denture, let's say. But I'd like you to see this space here. Here's the O-ball, the O-ring. This is a cross-section of the metal housing. There's actually space here so that when patient bites down on a denture, whole denture settles down a little bit because gum is resilient, right? Soft tissue is resilient. When it does, the denture actually does not contact the implant. So it's really a tissue-supported implant-retained denture. And that's the reason why we could load these cases when they have the initial stability that we need. So it's a tissue-supported, not implant-supported restoration. When I went to Europe a few years ago, I saw a lot of these small cars. But now in California, actually, I'm seeing more and more of these. Okay, and when you have a tight space like this, sometimes the only thing that really fits may be the small diameter implants. Right? There are a lot of studies that validate the efficacy of mini implants in long-term situations. There are a lot of them out there by now. We just don't have time to discuss them. If you would like some, please email me. I'll supply you with some. So there are a lot of studies. This one 12-year retrospective study verified that there was 92% success rate in those terms. There are more applications of mini implants. So let me just go through some. We can use them for partial dentures. A lot of these patients, we may be transitioning them from where they are now with some questionable remaining natural teeth that may fail in what near future. And this is a case where a patient had actually two teeth that were almost failing. The crowns were coming off on a short post and et cetera. And we placed four implants, made a partial denture. And a few years later, sure enough, she lost those two teeth. And all we had to do was extract and make new denture. That's all we had to do. We nicely transitioned that patient from a partial to a full denture. Maxillary arches are a different game. Some of you know, that in mandible, we can get away with a lot of things. But in maxilla, you get away with very few. So the rules for the maxillary mini implants are slightly different. But when you follow the protocol, they can be very successful as well. And nice thing is that you can take away that palate. Again, most common reason for patients seeking an upper implant restoration is usually getting rid of that palate acrylic, right? So this can satisfy that need. You can do multiple restorations. This patient actually saw a couple of a surgical specialist who recommended some extensive bone grafting. She was a more health-oriented person. And she found me somehow and drove 30, 40 miles to my office. That's a lot in my area, by the way. She wanted to have smaller diameter implants without the grafting, and we did this. This is about 12, 13 years in function, very successfully at this time. I was told that some dentists only have mini implants in their office, only place mini implants for all patients. And I said, well, that doesn't sound good, right? By the same token, if you only have conventional diameter implants, you may be missing out on many opportunities to help a lot of patients with situations that are more suitable for small diameter implants than conventional ones. If there's one message that I'd like you to take away from my presentation today is this. All of you have or will have implant toolbox in your office. And It's going to have all the gadgets and gizmos that will help you do your cases better and faster and more effectively, right? And from now on, mini implant is just nothing more than a very effective tool that stays in your toolbox, not some mysterious classification of implants that only a few dentists use, but a common tool that belongs in your implant toolbox that can help your patients and your practice. Thank you for your time.
Thank you for that, Dr. Choi. And if you'd like to see more speakers from the 2017 symposium, head to chairsidelive.com and check out some of the other videos we've already posted. And keep tuning in for more to come. Well, that about wraps it up for this episode of Chairside Live. On behalf of everyone here at Glidewell Dental, thank you for watching, and I'll meet you right back here next time.